Component variants let you create different variations of components. So for example, if I have a button and I might want a light mode and a dark mode, or if I have a card layout, I might want a horizontal and a vertical version. So the question you might be asking is, why does this matter? Why do we care about these variants? Well, have you ever worked on a site that had seemingly thousands of components? And that is because you have a different component for each different variation of a layout or dark and light and so on and so forth. This simplifies that complexity for team members, especially when you have people building landing pages or other designers that are trying to stay consistent. And let's go ahead and jump in and show you a couple of ways to do this. So we'll start first with a button. We'll come in, we have this button component here, and we'll go ahead and edit that. Now, when we come up to this button right next to the selector field, this is our component variants button. And we can go ahead and add a new variant. We'll call this one secondary. So this will be our secondary button. Now, when I come here, I am in the secondary variant, so any styling changes I make here will apply to this second variation. So for example, let's come down and change our background. Instead of white, let's go ahead and choose transparent. So now with our type, we need to change the type color. We'll go ahead and change that to white. And then for our borders, let's go ahead and change that as well to white. Okay, great. Now, when I click out, you'll notice we go back to the base variation, which is the original. So we'll just duplicate our button here. We'll select our new button, and we can change the variant to secondary. Okay, great. Now we have a single component with two different variations, a base and a secondary, so a light and a dark. But there's another thing I want to make sure that we highlight here, and that is that there is the concept of inheritance. So for example, if I come back into this base variation and I edit this, let's say for the sake of illustration, we just add an underline to the text here. You'll notice right away that the secondary variation also got the underline on the text. So anything that you make as a change to the primary will carry over to the secondary as long as you have not overridden that on the secondary. So we have this concept of inheritance, but maybe I don't want the underline on the secondary. I can come in here and edit this. And if we come down to type here and just go ahead and remove the underline. Now we have the best of both worlds. I have the underline on the primary or the base variation, and on the secondary variation, I have removed the underline. So inheritance applies, but you can also override the inheritance. Okay, let's jump to our second example. We have a card layout here, and we'll just double click into this component, and I'll create a new variation here. We'll go ahead and call this one. We have a horizontal layout, first of all, but let's create a second variation that's vertical. And while we're here, we can go ahead and rename the base variation. We'll call this one horizontal. Okay, great. Now, we're in our vertical layout here, or at least our variation that we've called vertical so far. Let's go ahead and change it. So on our flex layout, we'll go ahead and go vertical on that. We'll come down and change the width to, let's say, maybe 18 rem. That looks about right. And one thing that's a little different on the vertical-oriented layout here is that I want a little bit more margin between our card content right here and the image. So I'll select our card content and we'll go ahead and apply some margin here. Let's say maybe about 20. That should do it. Okay, great. As I click out, we go back to our horizontal. Let's go ahead and duplicate that. And I'll select this new one here and we can change this variant to vertical. Fantastic. So that's how we create another layout. Now, there's one thing to keep in mind as far as responsiveness is concerned and variants. If I come up to our breakpoints here and let's go to tablet, if I change this one to our vertical layout on our tablet breakpoint, now as I switch back to our desktop, you'll notice it's still vertical. So these variants don't apply between breakpoints. Instead, what you want to do is you want to make sure that you're designing your different variants to be responsive. So while you go ahead and edit that variant, you want to make sure it's responsive. So for example, let's come back to our tablet breakpoint. And while I'm on our tablet breakpoint, I can change the padding here. For example, we'll go ahead and just change this down to maybe somewhere around 20 as well. And then as I switch back to our desktop, you'll see the padding is actually at 30. So the responsiveness is actually in the styling and not in the variance itself. So that's component variants in Webflow. I hope you use those to simplify your design system and maintain consistency while you and your team build out your site.